Hello students, how are you? Are you doing maths practice or not? I hope that you are doing. So yeah, we are going to start here dividing by greater two-digit divisor. Okay, that means as you have learned already how to divide with 10, then other tens, then within 20, that means with 14, then 18, 17, 19, right? Now we will explore more and greater two-digit divisor we will use to solve our problems. Okay, so here I will show you with three-digit dividend. Okay, so that means a dividend is three-digit, and with the two-digit divisor how we can divide. Okay, so the example I have taken here, actually it is from exercise 4.4, one numbers a number. Okay, so here it is given that we have to divide this one with 27. Okay, so this is the question. Now we have to write it first like this. Okay, and as you know, I have already told you that earlier when we are using the, you know, estimation method, so there also we used to guess, right? So here first of all, what you have to see, you can see I have touched a page here. So here you can see 27 is less than 86, right? So 27 is our divisor, and 86 is our 86, we are considering the two digit, okay, from our dividend, that is 864. So as 27 is smaller, so yes, we can consider 86, right? We can consider two digit. Okay, so here two digit. Okay, now you can see, as I told you, there are enough tens. Okay, the quotient will begin from the tens place. So as you can see, 86, when we are multiplying 27 with 3, then we are getting 81. And as we have considered here what two digit number, so the quotient will start from what? The quotient will start from tens place. Okay, now we have to think of that what will be the quotient. Okay, so first of all, you have to think the numbers, that means what number you will take, either two digit or three digit, and by that you will come to know that from where your quotient will start. Okay, so as you can see, we have taken two digit number, so our quotient is starting from tens place. Now we have to think that how many times it will go. So 27 divided by 86 we have to think, and if we cover the one digit from ones place, then we will see 2 and 8, and we know that 2 4 ja 8. So from 4, 4 is the our what, estimated quotient, and with that we can, you know, multiply with 27 to get quotient. Okay, so here you can see, so with 4 if we multiply, then we will get 108, which is more than 86. So that's why we have to, you know, reduce the number. We have to try smaller number, right? So 27 into 3 is 81. So yes, the remainder, that means 86 and 81, if we subtract, then we'll get 5 as our remainder. So that means yes, this is the number we have to choose as our first quotient. Okay, so first number of the quotient we get, that is 3. Okay, so the remainder is 5. Now this 4 will come down. Okay, so 54, and now we have to see how many times it goes. So again, similar process here, you have to cover 7 and 4. So you know, 2 2 ja 4. Okay, here we are having 5, because 3 2 ja is 6, so it is more. So you have to try with what, 2. So 27 2 ja 54. So yes, 54 is equal to 54. Therefore the remainder is 0 and the quotient is 32. So here your division is complete. Okay, so like this way you have to solve the other problems also. So I will show one more from one numbers f number. Okay, so here it is given 470 divided by 55. So I will show you how to do this step by step. According to the question, I have written here 470 divided by 55. Now, the first step we have to see whether this two-digit number is divisible or we can divide it or not. So, 47 here 55. So, 55 is greater than 47. So, we cannot consider two-digit number. We have to consider whole this number, right? Three-digit number. So, 470. So, if we are considering three-digit number, then the quotient will start from where? This ones place, right? Because this is the last place from where we have to start. So, yes, ones place. So, we have to consider 470 divided by 55. So, now you have to just cover the first number and here also first number. So, you can see 5 and 47, right? So, 5 9 ja 45. Yes. So, you are getting your estimated quotient 9. So, 55 into 9 if you do, you will get 495. So, 495 is greater. So, from that point, we come to know that we have to try for what? Some smaller number. So, I am using the next smaller number, that is 8. 55 into 8. If we do, we will get 440. Okay. So, if we subtract it, we will get 30. So, you can see 30 is less than 55. So, yes, 30 will be our remainder and our quotient will be what? 8. Because 55, 8 ja 440 and after subtraction we are getting our remainder. Okay, in this way you have to do the other numbers also from your exercise. I will show you more example, but try to do
now
like
I will
this.
Show you four digit dividend.
That means if you are having four digit dividend, then how can you divide it? So we have 8968 divided by 52. Okay, so this is also from your exercise. Okay, so I am taking it as an example. Okay, to make you understand. So, here we have to divide this number with 52. Okay, so first of all, we will try with two digit number. 89 is greater than 52. Therefore, you can consider this two digit number. Okay, so now we have to remove these two number. Okay, so here we have 5 and here we have 8. So, 5 1 ja we can give, right? So, yes, 52 1 ja will be 52. Okay, we are considering our estimated quotient here. Okay, so after multiplying, we are getting 52. After subtracting, we are getting 37. Okay, and 37 is smaller than 52. Then the next digit will come down, right? So, 6. So, now it become 376. Okay. Again, same process we have to follow. We have to cover this number and here also. Okay. So, now 5 is our divisor. 37 is our dividend. So, 5, 7 ja 35. Right, students? So, yes. With 7, we can try. So, 7 into 52, if we do, we will get 364. Okay. So, if we subtract this, we are getting 12. Okay. 6 minus 4, 2. 7 minus 6 will be 1. Okay. Now, again, we have one more number. So, that one will come down. So, now our dividend is 128. Okay. And here it is 52. Okay. So, now again, we have to see by covering. So, 5 and here 12. Okay. We know that 5, 2, ja 10. So, with 2, we can try. Okay. So, 52 into 2 if we do, we are getting 104, right? So, after subtraction, we are getting 24. So, 24 is less than 52. So, this is the time you have to stop and 24 is our remainder and 172 is our quotient. Okay, students. So, this one I am saying you by, you know, here all the estimated quotient are exactly, you know, getting, we are exactly getting the numbers. Sometimes you may, you know, little bit increase the number or decrease the number, okay, according to your, like, you know, dividend, okay. So, but in this case, we are getting it, like, you know, whatever the estimated quotient we are getting by multiplying with the divisor, we are getting it. But in some cases, as you have shown just now, I have shown you, okay. So, sometime it may be more. So, at that time, we have to reduce it, okay. We have to try with some smaller number. And if it comes smaller number, then we have to try with some bigger number, okay. So, your division is complete. Now, you have to check. Okay, so the process for checking is dividend is equals to divisor into quotient plus remainder. So our divisor is what? 52. Our quotient is 172 and our remainder is 24. So that one I have written here, 52 into 172 plus remainder 24. So after multiplication, this 2, and after adding, we are getting this one as our answer, which is matching with the dividend given in the question. So that means your answer is definitely correct. Students, for some bigger number also, you can get 2-digit quotient. Okay, so let me show you how you can get it. So the question is 2164 divided by 23. Okay, so here 21 we cannot consider because 21 is less than 23. So here we have to consider 3-digit number. Okay, that means 216. Therefore, our quotient will start from where? From the tens place. Okay, so 216 and here 23. So again, you cover the ones place number. So now 2 and 21. Okay, so here how many times it goes? 10 times, right, students? Okay, so I'll show you in here. Okay, so 2 into 10, if we do, we are getting 210, right? But if we do 23 into 10, we will get what? 230, which is greater than what? 216. So we have to what? Reduce the number, right? So we will try with 9. Okay, so if we try with 9, then we will get 207. Okay, so 9 times we have to give and 207. So after subtraction, we are getting 9 as our remainder here. So as 4 is left, so this one will come down. So 94. And here you are having 23. Right, students? So here you can see 23 divided by 94. So again, you cover this and 2 is our divisor, 9 is our dividend. So you know 4 to 8, right, students? So with 4 we can try. So 23 into 4 if we try, so the answer will be 92. Okay, so yes, 92, we can compare here, right? 94 is greater, so we can write it. So 4 times 92 and the remainder is what? 2. Okay, and this one is the quotient. Okay, so this one is the wrap portion. For understanding, I have shown you here. You can also do it in your right side of your copy by writing above rough like this way. Okay, so this is how you can get 2-digit quotient. Now I will show you 0 in the quotient. Okay, it is very, very important. Okay, students, so try to listen it properly. Okay, and try to understand. So 0 in the quotient, that means how we can get 0 in our quotient. So here one example is there, 9236 divided by 71. Okay, so I've written like that way. Okay, so our first step is to see these two number, 92 and here 71. So obviously 92 is greater than 71. We can consider this 2-digit number. So if we do 2 times of 71, then it is more than 92. So that's why we will consider only one time. Or you can place like this way. So only one time it will go, 7, 1 is 7 and 2 will be the remainder. So yes, our estimated quotient is 1. So we'll try with 1. 71. After subtraction, we are getting 21. So this 3 will come here, right, students? So here you can see 213 divided by 71. Okay, students? So again, we'll cover. And here you can see 3, 7, 21, right? So we are exactly getting it. So 71 into 3, if we do, we are getting exactly 213, right? So after subtraction, we are getting 0. Now, one more digit is left. So according to the rule, this will come down, right? Okay, 6. But this is not the time you have to stop because you have left your ones place number. Okay, ones place is blank, but you can't keep this ones place blank. Okay, because any number that starts with what? Ones place, Right. So one's place cannot be empty. So that is why you have to add zero here. That means you have to write zero here, because anything we are multiplying with the zero will give us zero. Right, students? So 71 zeros are zero. After subtracting, we are getting 6 as our remainder. Okay. So you can see 6 is our remainder and 130 is our quotient. Okay. So do not make this type of mistake that you are only writing 13 and 6 as our remainder. Don't write like that way, because one's place cannot be empty. We are starting with what? 2-digit number. So the place we are starting from what? 100 place, right? Because this one is 4-digit number. So we are starting from 100 place. Okay, then it goes to tens place and then ones place. So ones place cannot be empty. So that is why we are writing zero here. Now let's see some questions from your exercise. Exercise 4.4, question number 1, divide. Check your answer. After division, you have to check also. I am solving B number 525 divided by 32. So I've written here. Okay. So now we have to see the first 2-digit. So 52 and 32. Obviously, we can consider this 2-digit number. Then we have to cover this. So 5 and here it is 3. So 3 1 is 3, because 3 2 is 6. So our estimated quotient is 1. So we have to write with we have to multiply 1 with 32. So one time if we do, we'll get 32. After doing the subtraction, we are getting 20. Okay. Then this 5 will come here. Okay. So now again, we are getting 205. So 32, with 32, we have to divide. So now let's estimate again. So here you can see 3 6 is 18. Okay. Because 3 7 is 21. So it is more than 20. So we have to estimate, our estimated quotient is 6 times. So 32 into 6, if we do, we will get 192. Okay. So after subtraction, we are getting 13 as our what? Remainder. Okay. Now, in your question, it is said that check your answer. So you have to write like this, check. Then you have to write divisor into quotient plus remainder. After multiplying these two, you will get 512 plus 13 will give you 525. So you can see the dividend is matching. So yes, your answer is correct. Similarly, I have solved for H number, then D number. Okay. So here you can see same procedure I'm following. Okay. 27. Here we have to consider 83. Okay. So 83, if we consider, then we have to see like this. So 3 6 is 8. So yes, 3 can be our estimated quotient. So that is why 27 into 3 will give us 81. After subtraction, you'll get 2 and 7 will come here. So 27 1 is 27. Okay. So here remainder is 0. So you have to write in the place of remainder 0. And after that, you have to multiply the quotient and divisor. Then you will get this. Okay. Next, D number, here also same procedure. 56 is there. Okay, 562 and here 78. So if you consider 56, you can't do that, because 78 is greater. So what do you have to do? You have to consider both 3-digit number, right? 562. Students, this one you see here, I have placed this one wrongly, right? Because we have to start from where? One's place. So this 7 should be here, not here. Okay. So you do not make this type of mistake. Okay. So when you are considering 3-digit number here. Okay. So that means up to last you are considering, right? So from the last you have to start. That means the one's place. Okay. So do not make this type of mistake. Okay. So after estimation like this way, 7, 7 is 49. And 7 8 are 56. So 7 8 if 78 into 8, if we do, it become more than 562. So therefore we have to reduce it. Okay. So in place of 8, I am writing 7. So 78 into 7, if we do, we are getting 546, and the remainder is 16, which is less than the divisor. Therefore 7 is our quotient and 16 is our remainder. Here you have to check, that means divisor into quotient plus remainder. Okay. So after multiplication we are getting this plus 16 will give us the dividend, that is 562. Question number 3, divide. Okay, so C number, you can see I have written 6014 divided by 83. So I have written, okay. Now, you have to see here 60 and here 83, which is more, right, than 60. So we have to consider what, students? We have to consider 3 digits. So 601 we have to consider, okay. Now, you have to estimate. So if I cover this and this, so you can see 60, right? So 7, 8 ja 56, right? And 8 8 ja 64, so that is more. So we have to consider what? 7. So 83 into 7, if we do, we are getting 581. After subtraction, we are getting 20, and 4 is remain here, so 4 will come here, so 204. Now again we can estimate like this way, okay? So we know 8 2 ja what? 16, okay, and 8 3 ja, here it is 20, right? So if we do 8 3 ja, then it will become 24, so which is more than 20, right? So therefore we have to consider 2. So 83 into 2, 166, and after subtraction we are getting 38. 38 is less than 83, so therefore this is the remainder and this is the quotient. Here F number 9755 divided by 46. Here also same procedure we have to follow, students, but here you can consider this 2-digit number because 97 is greater than 46. So 2 times if we do, we'll get this one, and after subtraction we are getting 5. 5 will come down again one time, so then 9 is the remainder, again 5 will come, and with 2 if we do, we are getting 92, then 3 is the remainder, okay? So here you can see we are getting how 3 digit quotient, right, students? Now 3 number, watch out for zeros. So there may be chances of getting 0, okay? Let's see. D number, 2829 divided by 47. So here I have written here. So 28 we cannot consider. So we have to consider 3 digits, 282. Okay. So if we cover this number, we are getting 28. Okay. So 64 ja 24, right, students? So we can consider that. So 47 into 6, if we do, we are getting exactly 282. Okay, so after subtraction, definitely we are getting 0, right? So 9 will come here. As I told you, students, ones place cannot be empty, right? So as you know, 3 digit we are considering, so we will start from here, from the tens place, right? So ones place cannot be empty, so we have to put 0 here, and 0 into something will give you 0. Then after subtraction you are getting your remainder. So 9 is the remainder and the quotient is 60. Next, H number, 7208 divided by 36. So yes, 72 you can consider, right, students? Because 72 is greater than 36, then we have to estimate, right? So if we do cover like this, so 7 2 ja 6, right? Sorry, 3 2 ja 6, right? And 6 is less than 7, so we can consider it. So 36 into 2, if we do, we are getting exactly 72. Okay, after subtraction, we are getting 0. Now, here also we are having 0, so this 0 will come down, okay? 0. Now, 0 cannot be we cannot divide 0 with 36, right, students? So therefore this 8 should be this 8 should come here, right? 8 should be there. So if we are bringing 8 here, then we have to put 1 0, okay? Because at one step we can only bring one number at a time. So after subtraction we are bringing this 0 here, right? So at a time we cannot bring it here, okay? Because at a time we have to bring only one number, okay? So 0 has already came here, right? So 8 we cannot bring it here, so that's why we have to put 0 here. So anything with multiplying with the 0 will give you 0. So 0 minus 0 will be 0, then this 8 will come, right? So when 8 will come, so students, you can see here 8 is smaller than 36, right? So here you have to see whether your ones place is empty or what. So you can see only we have these two number. Ones place, there is nothing. But you know that ones place cannot be empty. So that's why you have to add 0 here. And if you put 0, then 0 into 36 will give you 0. And after subtraction, we will get our remainder as 8. Okay. So students, do not get mess over here. Always you remember that ones place cannot be empty. So that is why we have to put 0 there, because anything we are multiplying with 0 will give us 0. Okay. So that is the trick you have to apply here. And sometimes, suppose in this case, when there is not enough number to divide with, then we have to bring the next number down, right? So in that case, directly you cannot bring. Okay, so for that you have to put 0, and then only that number can come down in the next step, because at a time only one number can come down. Okay students, so these two rule you just keep remember, and then there will be no problem while solving. Okay students, now we will do mixed problem. So that is your question number 4. So C number is given 9430 divided by 82. So yes, we are considering this 94 we can consider, because 82 is less. So one time 82, then 12 is the remainder, 3 will come here, again 82, then 41 is the remainder, 0 will come here, and 5 ja 410. So the remainder is 0, and the quotient is 115. G number 7346 divided by 37. So here also you can see 73. So 73 is greater than 37, so we can consider it. So one time if we do, we will get our remainder as 36, then 4 will come here, so now it become 364. Okay, so after estimating we are getting 9. So 9 into 37 if we do, we will get 333. Okay, and remainder we are getting 31. Again 6 is there, so 6 will come here. Okay, so 316. If we do 8 times, if we multiply with 37, we will get 296. After subtraction, we are getting 20. So 20 is the remainder, and 198 is our quotient. Okay students, so like this way you have to solve. I hope that you understood, and there are a lot of problems in exercise 4.4. So you do it, okay, and we will do problem solving in our next video. Thank you so much.